What do you want? Leave us alone. Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's the Artcast. Let's do some work. Yeah, let's do some art. I want to show you guys something though. This week I worked on a shot from my animated Berserkernaut little cartoon movie. I'm not quite sure what to even call this thing. Let me show you guys the art first. These were the roughs. This was my storyboard right here. And I just roughed out this scene. All it was this shot right here of him running. And from that I took and drew these four pieces right here, which is the four major key big moves in this run. One is a shot of him running with his right leg forward. The other is a shot of him running with his left leg forward. And then there's two shots of him landing on each foot. So right foot and a left foot. I took those shots and I put them into After Effects and I animated this little test right here, which I thought came out pretty good. It gave me an indication of I was on the right track. I then painted these shots up and painted a background, and then I put all of the stuff into After Effects and I came up with this right here. Yeah. Now that's a finished shot from the animation. So as I do this and I get more of these shots done, I've noticed it's kind of added to the momentum. And I feel myself kind of pushing, going, yeah, this is what I want. This is what I had in my head. I'm happy with what's going on right now. I feel like I'm on the right track. Let's talk about something. Let's talk about some art. So I was thinking about comics or your passion project, whatever that is. So fill in your thing whenever I say comics. I think I say comics as a fill-in kind of thing for everything because I still feel like I'm a comic book artist. And that was sort of like what I went after, even though a lot of what I went after throughout my life wasn't really comics. But comics was sort of the beginning inspiration. And it's sort of like always been my ideal version of what I'm doing, even though I feel like my comic is now an animated Berserkernaut cartoon, right? But I was thinking, you know, like when you start this kind of thing, like what is it? You know, what drives you to decide that you've got to make comics and nothing else? You know, like why did you pick that instead of opening up a grocery store or something? In my own case, it was sort of inspiration I took from things that I saw when I was younger. The movies and the comics, like when I was a kid, you know, that was the days of Raiders of the Lost Ark, Road Warrior, Escape from New York, you know, I mean, the original Star Wars, things like that. And I took great inspiration from those things, along with all of the stuff I was seeing, like repeated on television, you know. Like the classic horror movies and stuff. And then all the comics I was reading back then, too. You know, all the Marvel comics. They reprinted all the Marvel 60s comics. So we were all reading, you know, like the beginnings of the Fantastic Four and the Avengers and all that kind of stuff. And then along with that was all the great, you know, bigger, kind of more adult, I guess, magazines that had comics in them back then. Like the Savage Sword of Conan and Heavy Metal. And all that stuff was just sort of like raw inspiration that, you know, started to shape the clay of my mind into this idea of what I wanted to do. But it all starts with that inspiration, you know, that inspiration that pushes you into this decision and you sort of take this thing up. It's like you take up the quest, you know. And you become this almost monk that is trying to unravel the secrets of the universe, I guess. But by monk, I mean, you know, it's like a lifelong quest. It's like something that you start and you work your whole life towards understanding this thing and creating this thing. Even though it can be many things, you know, it's not just one project you're working on. It can be all of your projects that you've worked on all along. But it all sort of starts with that one decision. And it continues because you keep making these decisions to stay in this, you know, to not sort of give up and not quit. You know, when things get hard, you continue. And when you have to learn something, well, you learn it. And when you have to figure out something, well, you figure it out. And you continue on and on and on. And it's all driven by these sort of decisions. I had a comic that I self-published a while ago called Jack the Giant Killer. I mean, this was quite a while ago, I'd say, like, I mean, this is probably going back almost 10 years now. And it was when I first got on the internet. And I was like, wow, look at this. The internet, you know, it's the whole world's right here at my fingertips. I got to do a comic, you know. And I had this idea to do this comic called Jack the Giant Killer. And it was like, it was going to be like a 3-issue miniseries. And the first one was kind of going to tell the original myth, you know, the original fairy tale. And then on the second 2 issues, I was going to continue on with that story and tell what happened after. And at that time, I was painting fantasy paintings, so I wanted to do it, you know, the covers in oil, you know, and make them really, you know, really lush and perfect. And then the inside was going to be all pencil drawings, stuff like I was doing in my sketchbook at the time, which back then was maybe a little bit more delicate than I do now. It was definitely a very different style back then, you know. And I remember I got the first one done, and I printed it at, I think I printed it at Lulu. There was a print-on-demand place called Lulu at the time. This was a ways back. I mean, it was back before Kablam ever came along or any of the other print-on-demand comic places. And I remember I had to pay, like I printed up some books with like a $5 price tag, and I think I was paying like $7 for these books. And I took them up to the comic shop and just sold them at a loss. You know, but I mean, it was early days, you know. It was the early days of all this stuff. After the first issue, and as I was working on the second one, I was just like, there's just no money here. Even though I'm on the internet and I have this world audience, and I have a print-on-demand printer that can print one comic, you know, in color, all these crazy new, you know, innovations have come along. You know, they weren't quite where I needed them to be, and I lost hope in the project, and I quit. And I still got a couple of those on my shelf here at the house, and I pick them up, and I always think, oh, I should have finished that book. It would have been so good, you know. It would have been so good, whether I made money on it or not. It would have been worth doing. And that's the thing, you know, is I made the decision to stop. Nothing really did stop me, you know. Lulu and their $6 price tag for print-on-demand really didn't stop me. That was something that I could have figured a way around. You know, there was no crowdfunding or anything like that. And I was also working a normal, you know, job. I believe I was painting at the time. Painting houses, not art. But I had nights, I had weekends. I had time to do it. I stopped. It didn't stop me. I stopped. You know, we're strong enough to make that decision in the beginning to start all this. All of us that are listening to this probably are artists. And we were all strong enough to make that decision in the beginning to start this and also make a whole bunch of decisions along the way to move forward with it against adversity, you know. But we just kept going anyway, you know. We just kept pushing through and pushing through and pushing through. So why did I get Jack the Giant Killer drawn on the shelf and then I stopped? I never did the next one. You know, I don't know. I wish I had the answer for that. I wish I had the answer, and I hope I'm not doing the same thing with the Berserker Knot. I really hope I'm not, you know, just telling myself a lie about the animation and I'm just giving up on the Berserker mount. I don't think I am, though. I don't think I am. But my point isn't so much to, you know, look back over my own life and do some sort of self-examination. I do that enough. I think way too much about myself. I'm probably too self-obsessed, actually. But it was more to point out that you're strong enough to make that first decision, the second, the third, the tenth, the hundredth, the thousandth decision to go on. But then there's something about it when you get right to the end, when you get so close after all this work. We're all standing at the end of a huge long trail, right? Every one of us. To get here took so much effort and so much work and so many years. The decision to take that next step or to go to the rest of the way, go to the completion of your thing, your project, your comic or your animation or whatever it is, it almost should be the easiest and the most obvious decision. But I think sometimes because it's at the end of the trail, we make it into the hardest decision. You know, the hardest one to get past. But, you know, ultimately it's still just a decision. Just make it and step on out there and keep going. That's it, guys. Like, subscribe, all that stuff. Check me out on Patreon if you want to support the channel. See you next time.